Next, we're going to talk about the tax multiplier. The tax multiplier tells us how much output will be lost as a result of an increase in tax. Or you could say, it tells us how much output will be gained as a result of a tax cut. So here is intuition. If your tax goes up, then output goes down. If your tax goes down, then output goes up. Now, if you're taxed, you're going to cut your consumption, but your consumption cut is not going to be as big as the increase in tax. So for example, if your MPC is equal to 0.9 and tax increased by $100, in this case, you are going to cut your consumption by $90 and you're going to cut your saving by $10. So if your tax increases, then some consumption and some saving will be lost. But next, I'm going to explain how the tax multiplier works. Suppose MPC is equal to 0.9 and the initial tax increase is $100. With this tax increase, I am going to cut my consumption by 90. Why is it 90? Because 100 times MPC 0.9 will give you 90. So that's the amount of consumption I'm going to cut. And I'm also going to cut my saving by $10. So when I cut my consumption $90, that means the person that I will shop from, I would have shopped from, and I would have spent $90, would lose income by $90 because I'm cutting my consumption, so the other person is not making that $90 income from me. So that other person will lose income by $90. And as a result, that person is going to cut his or her or their consumption by $81. Why 81? Because our MPC is equal to 0.9, and 90 times 0.9 is equal to $81. So this person's cut of consumption is also going to cause someone else to lose the income by $81. And this process is going to continue. So our output loss will be equal to 90 plus 81 and so on and so forth. Eventually, our output loss will sum up to $900. So you can see initially our tax was just increased by $100, but the output goes down by 900. So our output loss, so negative 900, divided by our initial tax increase 100, is equal to negative 9. Therefore, your tax multiplier is equal to negative 9. Here is a formula for our tax multiplier. Our tax multiplier is equal to negative MPC over MPS. So our MPC in our example is equal to 0.9. Then our tax multiplier will be equal to negative 0.9 over 0.1, which gives you negative 9. So if the tax increased by 100, that means our output will go down by how much? Well, negative 9 times 100, which is negative 900. So your output would drop by 900. Now let's take a look at how different MPC would change the effect of a tax on output. So we know the changing output is equal to tax multiplier times the change in tax. Now, suppose our tax increased by 100 and we're going to start with a higher MPC. We know that other things equal, typically poor people will have a higher MPC because they're desperate and more likely to spend the entire paycheck. So given a relatively higher MPC, say MPC is equal to 0.9, then our tax multiplier is equal to negative MPC over MPS, and that gives you negative 9. Which means if your tax increases by 100, that means your output is going to go down by 900. And next, let's take a look at a smaller MPC. So we know that wealthy people typically have a lower MPC because they are not as desperate and they are not going to spend most part of their paycheck. So they have a lower MPC. So suppose MPC is equal to 0.2, then our tax multiplier is equal to negative MPC over MPS, which gives you negative 1/4. So in this case, if your tax goes up by 100, then your output is going to go down by 25, because negative a quarter times 100 is equal to negative 25. So you know the output will drop by 25. Well, you can see that there is a big difference. If MPC is big, then the output drops by 900. But if MPC is small, then output only drops by 25. So here is the main reason why we typically have progressive tax. Because the higher the MPC, the more the output drop. So you don't want to tax the poor people a lot. You prefer to tax the rich people, because when you tax the rich people, it's not going to have such a big negative impact on our output. Let's try a practice question. Suppose your MPC is equal to 0.8. What is the tax multiplier? And after you calculate that, let's say if there is a tax cut in the amount of $1,000, would the output go up or down, and by how much? So now you want to pause the video and then work on that yourself. Later on, we're going to compare our answers.